Who shall lay anything? Anything. Who shall lay anything? Tell a neighbor anything.
Anything.
You know, anything is anything. No? But the one I commit and the one that I didn't commit, all of them are anything. That's to say, in spite of your mistake, in spite of your shortcoming, nobody has the moral right to charge you. You didn't hear that?
Yes, sir. I hear you, sir.
Even if you were guilty of the crime,
yes,
nobody has the moral right in the face of foreknowledge, predestination, election, justification, glorification. Nobody can condemn you.
Yes, sir.
Even if you are caught with evidence,
yes,
even if you are caught with evidence, that is, you are carrying evidence.
Yes,
Jesus will look at you and say, neither do I condemn you. Go and say no. This is too radical for religion. If you're hearing, shout, I hear you. Didn't they catch the woman in the very act? They caught her in the very act. That means when they brought her to Jesus, they brought her without clothes. Because for you to condemn somebody, you must have hard evidence. They wouldn't have allowed her dressed up, because if she had dressed up, it will be her witness against their witness. It will be their word against her word. But they must have brought her stark so that Jesus will see her the way they caught her, in the face of core evidence. But the problem is, the man is missing. One person does not commit adultery. No, one person does not commit adultery. There must be two people. And if they caught her in the act, means two of them were in action when they caught them. Where is the man? I want the man. Hold your neighbor, say, show me that man. They have protected the man. It is called selective morality. What is it called? Selective morality. And up till today, they have not produced the man. They are still protecting the man. The law is wicked. The law does not favor a woman. The law of Moses favors a man. It doesn't, because the Pharisees and the Sadducees were men, and they were the protectors of the law. So they used the law to cover themselves. Selective morality. When they brought her to Jesus, Jesus said, oh. They said, the law of Moses says stone her. Grace, what do you say? Now Jesus cannot say stone her. If he says stone her, he came to save sinners. He will defeat his purpose. And he cannot say ignore Moses, because he came to fulfill the law. If he say ignore Moses, he will defeat his purpose. So that's why it's temptation. He can't say stone her. He can't say ignore Moses. That's why it's temptation. So what did Jesus do? To defeat them, because under the law, nobody can be perfect. So he went back to their law and used the law to defeat them. What does the law say? He that breaks one has broken all. So he now said to them, any of you that is without sin, cast the first stone. Then they remember their small, small mistakes. One by one, they began to walk away. I feel like I'm preaching right now. I feel like I'm preaching right now. God punished the devil. Then Jesus lifted his head and said, woman, where are thine accusers? Has no man condemned you? She said, no man. Then Jesus said, neither do I condemn you. Who shall lay charge? Who shall lay charge against God's elect? Lift your two hands and shout, I am elected by God. No charge against me. Right now and forever. Can I hear an eternal amen? Sit down. Let's push this thing. Let's push this. Dados. Religion can't handle this one. It's too hot for religion. Higa ba 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 ba. Ish. Zubalata. Hey, put it back. Romans. Yeah, yeah. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died. Yea, rather, that is risen again. Who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. You don't need an intercessor, except you have mistakes. The reason why you will need an intercessor is because you have mistakes.
Yes, sir.
He didn't only die. He died to pay for sin. He rose to justify the sinner. Then he opened an office of advocacy. Jesus opened an advocacy for the sinner, so that sin can never take a man to hell.
Yes, sir.
Because Jesus' advocacy covers the mistakes of the believer. His advocacy, the advocate general of the church. And I have news for you. The advocate general's father is a chief judge. How can he lose a case? So Jesus said, no man that the father has given me is lost. All that the father has given me, no one is lost. Why? I'm the intercessor and my father is the chief judge. It's a family business. He said, all that the father has given me, none is lost. He said, no man can pluck you out of my hand. My father, the chief judge, that gave you to my custody as the advocate, is greater than all. Zazazozozozo. Somebody touch your neighbor, shout glory. Leave that in my brother. Kayana. Menga. Go back. Romans. Elebota. Put it back. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Not from our love for Christ. Wait. Let's do English language. Not from our love for Christ, but from the love. It's called proton agape. That's the Greek word, proton agape. That is the love that Christ has given us. Not our love, his love. Who shall separate us? Who shall separate us from proton agape, from the love of God? Not that we love God, but that he loved us. So it's his love that is keeping us. It's not our love keeping us. It's his love that is keeping us. And nobody can separate us from that love. We are not the one holding him. He's the one holding us. You didn't hear that. See, if I was the one holding him, when my hands are weak, I could leave him. But now in this case, he knew that I cannot hold him. So what he did is he used his mega hands to hold me. So even when I'm weak, he's holding me. Even when I fall inside his hand. Kebatana. Who shall separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ? Then he now said, shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword, as it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. We are not more than conquerors because we pray well. We are not more than conquerors because we fast hard. We are not more than conquerors because we are good guys. We are more than conquerors through him that loved us. I'm teaching good here. Next verse. For I'm persuaded. Kabayata. Are you persuaded?
Yes,
I'm persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to, even things that I have not seen, cannot separate me. Nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is where? Where is the love of God? Where are you? Where is the love of God? Where are you? So you are in Christ's love, kept. Kept. Eternally kept in the love of Christ. I stand in his love. I live in his love. Yeah.